not at all. You know, I never really was big on asking questions. You know, this is home for me, you know, being on this side. I've always envisioned myself being a coach, if not at the University of Tennessee, somewhere else. But, you know, I'm very appreciative of Coach Jones and the opportunity to come learn under Coach Jones and his staff as well. You're talking about a man that's full of vision, his passion and everything, and where we've been as a program, I think under Coach Jones, you know, he's laid that foundation. And just like any house that's going to be built, it starts with the foundation. Then there's the framework. You never just put the roof on first. So, you know, there's going to be some challenges ahead. But how he started this program out, I think it's unreal. You know, like I said, I continue to say I've been blown away by his approach and how he's handled everything. And moving forward, how he will continue to do that. I know the players are very excited about it. You know, he's the ultimate players coach, and he's got an unbelievable staff as well. I mean, you're talking about a diligent head coach, a diligent staff. These guys are very high energy guys, very knowledgeable, great teachers and developers of young men. So for myself, it's just great to be around and learn from day to day.
How much did you miss college football, being out of it for a while?
It was rough. I mean, you know, being on the radio every day, you know, and especially hearing the way things have been going over the last couple of years, and the calls and the negativity and everything that you had to talk about on a day-to-day basis is not what I envisioned when I actually went into radio. And just being my alma mater, you know, those things really hurt you as a former player. And former players, we always talk about that. We want to see it get back to prominence. But I think that, you know, we're just all excited. You know, what Coach Jones has been able to do in reaching out to the former players, those guys are all excited about Coach Jones. He's been doing everything that he's had to, but he hadn't did it because he had to. He does it because I think that's the type of guy he is. I know that's the type of guy he is. He wants to establish those relationships. And when I say his passion is great, his vision is great, it's just that. And I think the coaches echo his sentiment and what he's trying to do. And I think these players, they're fired up about it. And you can see it in their eyes when they come into that meeting room. And they want to win. And, you know, the biggest thing the last couple of years has been, you know, the ability to trust. And I think it showed out on the football field. But, you know, his approach to the things that he's bringing to the program, and not just on the football field, but off the field, building these football players and the young men and student athletes. I think these guys, you know, will see the light at the end of the tunnel. But like I said, it's not going to be an overnight fix with anything. You know, it's a process. You know, I keep referring back to that house. I know even if it's an apartment, if you have a house or apartment, you know, they just didn't throw the roof on and you moved in. You know, it was a process and steps that they had to go through. But I think so far so good with that foundation being laid.
Describe your role in detail in building that house.
Well, my role is to assist. You know, I'm going to be working with the defense, of course, and Willie Martinez in the secondary. I'm going to be learning from everyone. This is my first year on the job, so anything I can take, any information that I can get from them, I keep my notepad and notebook with me. You know, I'm all about learning right now and working with the secondary. Coach Martinez is, you know, a great coach. You know, it's what he teaches. You know, he's all about the young men, loving them up, coaching them hard, but loving them up as well. He's been in a lot of different places, been successful at those places. So for me, you know, it's great to come in and learn on a guy like Willie Martinez, just a huge and intense and passion for the job that he does. So I'm blessed in that regard to be learning under him in year one. So I'll be working with those guys, but also, you know, just the contact day to day with myself and these players that, you know, I've already known, but now the ability to get in depth with those guys and, you know, be able to refer to the past and teach them about, you know, the history and tradition of Tennessee, because history will always be a part of the future. And I think you cannot leave that out. Coach Jones has done a great job in stressing that to all the players, and I think it's very important. But like I said, it's been great so far. You know, it's a big recruiting season, and I tell you, these guys are passionate. They've been out hitting it hard and doing everything that they have to. And it's been a welcoming experience for me. And like I said, you know, Coach Jones, his vision has been unbelievable so far. And everything that he's done, he set the tone already with the team, with the former players, and doing different things. So that foundation is laid. But again, you know, it's not an overnight fix. It's not going to be easy. But it's a process that he relishes, and he's looking forward to continuing on. And, you know, one of the things that was interesting to me when we were talking, when he first offered me the position, you know, I asked him a question. I say, Coach, where do you see yourself? He said, I see myself retiring here in Tennessee. You know, and those are things that stability we've been lacking here. He wanted this position, and so far, so good for me. And like I say, I continue to say I've been blown away by, you know, his just attention to detail, his commitment to building that brand back up to where it needs to be. I mean, this is one of the best universities in the country. I know it hadn't looked like that in the last couple of years, and being a former player and being a part of that, just look forward to having a hand in that and assisting any way I can.
Terry, I know you guys had your first team meeting the other night. It sounded like you got a pretty warm reception from the players. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, it was pretty cool, man. You know, I know some of these guys previously from having a mic in my hand as well and interviewing them, but, you know, Coach Jones put it out there. You know, he wants these guys to know when, you know, former players come around. You don't have to be a first-round, second-round pick. You know, hey, if you put on that orange and you went out every day and you worked at it, you're part of this program. He wants to recognize that. But it was pretty cool to get, you know, just being back in that meeting room and having these young guys, you know, kind of acknowledge me in that way. I look forward to working with them and, you know, just giving back all that I have on and off the field, and life lessons I've learned over the years throughout my professional and college career as well.
Terry, you probably answer this, but some of the stuff that Butch has done with the former players, the meet and greets, having them here, having them in Nashville, just, you know, what kind of impact can that have for the former players, and how do you think they respond to that?
Well, I mean, I could tell you how they responded. They love it. Everything has been a success as far as that goes with the former players. I think how it works is you want those guys to be a part of your program. You know, I said this earlier in talking, you know, to move on in the future, you just can't discount history. That's always going to be a part of the future. And, you know, these guys, you know, they had their hand in helping build the brand of Tennessee, and you want to welcome those guys back. You know, he always stresses family. In order to be successful, you have to be a close-knit unit, and that involves the players that previously played here. And those guys want to feel like they have a hand in it as well, whether it's coming around and working out, because, you know, knowledge is power. When those guys come around and some of these young players who maybe hadn't won the games like some you know, former players have, you know, get to share in those different things. They get to feel part of it. So many things are learned from those experiences and encounters with former players, not to mention relationships in other states, other cities, that you may have to lean on those guys for in the future. Not just because that, but because they're part of the family and they want to come back. They want to be a part of it. I mean, tradition goes a long way when you're talking about recruiting and bringing young men in here, and what it means to play at the University in Tennessee and what that tradition and history really means. I mean, everybody wants to be a part of that, and hopefully their part is successful.
Terry, how tough was it for you to get back into coaching, knowing the grind it can be, and you having a family now, being a little bit older? Was it a tough decision for you to make?
No, not at all. Not at all. It was one of the easiest decisions I had to make, because that meant I had to leave Russell Smith. But no, not at all. But, you know, Russ is a great guy. But, you know, when my wife was on board, I let her know what I wanted to do and wanted to pursue it. You know, she was behind me 100%. She understood my passion and what I've been wanting to do for several years now, since I coached at the junior college level. And one of my reasons coming back here to Tennessee and getting my degree was to further my coaching career. Just so happens I ended up in the media, and to have the opportunity now, when she said she was on board, you know, it gave me everything in me to go out and really pursue it 100% aggressively and just attack it. And here I am, and just thankful for the opportunity.
Terry, what does your job description allow you to do, and not do maybe?
Well, you know, just assistant, really working with the DBs, working with Coach Martinez.
On the field?
You know, we'll see. We'll see how that works. I'm still trying to clear up some details and different things. But, you know, I will have a hand in working with these young men, assisting Coach Martinez and the defensive backs, and, you know, in all other areas of defense as well. So I'm looking forward to it. And, you know, I had an opportunity to catch up with guys and just meeting guys and get to know them, you know, away from the reporter side and the talk show host side of it. And, you know, it's been great, man. We've had some great, you know, heart-to-heart meetings, some intense meetings with some of those guys. It's just been fun, you know, getting to know one another. But this coaching staff, they do a great job of, you know, they bring that intensity each and every day. They bring that passion. Coach Jones is such a player's coach that you can see it in these guys' faces when they walk in the meeting, when we've had team meetings, that you can see the excitement. And I think that's a great start.
Are you allowed to make recruiting phone calls? Are you allowed
not,
to on-campus
you
recruit?
No, I am not too – I can't do much recruiting off-campus, of course. You know, if a recruit comes on campus, I can, you know, maybe talk to them there. But as far as recruiting goes right now, not my bag. We've got some great coaches out on the road that hit it hard every day. So I'm just sitting there, you know, soaking up all I can with those guys, taking notes. And when I do get that opportunity, I'll be prepared for it.
Terry, you got the coach speak thing down, man. You're doing good.
Well, I've always been a coach. You know, it's funny, man. The ability to change up, Russ, and you know how passionate I am about coaching, and you know, I've always said, always on the radio when I was a media guy, that I'm not a media guy. You know what I mean? This is what I really like to do, and you know, it's a heck of an opportunity. I'm gonna run with it, and I just look forward to it.
Now, are you giving any fashion advice, style tips to some of the coaches in there trying to get them right?
Well, no, I'm not doing that. Everybody has their own style. I have mine, and no, I hadn't done that. You know, I'm not gonna overstep my boundaries. I just got here. I'm the new kid on the block.
Are you gonna be able to use your influence or sway to lobby for alternate uniforms or anything like that with the balls?
Next question.
Take that as a yes.
Thanks, Terry.
I appreciate it.